What's up, Galactica Jinga? So hey, here with Jinga and Grow Strong. A quick video about grappling or BJJ in Capoeira. Now, there's many groups. If you go back and trace the ancestry of each lineage of each, so there's a lot of breakaway groups that they definitely have a lineage. Whether they trained in many different groups, but if you go back far enough, people that are loyal to their groups and stay in the groups have a little bit better way to track their lineage. And even if not, you could go back to see where these people got their information, which masters they trained with, who were their masters, and who were their masters, and go on and so forth. So remember that Capoeira was a martial art, a hidden martial art now, as you know. It's a lot of different things. Fun, exercise, expression, art, body expression, all that stuff. And then for some groups, they spend a little bit more time, doing more art than more martial, you know what I mean? So, which is fine. I can jam with both the music. I appreciate the martial arts aspect. And so our group, does grapple. Okay. So we do, it's passed down from his master, Mestre Loca's master, Cachiguara, was passed down to Mestre Loca, passed down to my master, Mr. Andrade Vagado, and then passed down to me, and which I passed down to my students, which you got to learn how to grapple. So what they taught us, a lot of locks, takedowns, arm bars, basic stuff, but they didn't teach us the little nuances that like Brazilian jiu-jitsu or even a wrestling, the small details, where your hips are supposed to be, where your leverage is supposed to be, all this other stuff, the big stuff to escape if a battle goes to the floor, and how to escape each little part. So that's where I started taking Brazilian jiu-jitsu, so I could really hone that art and really teach my students to the best of the ability, as a teacher. And so, and this is where Brazilian jiu-jitsu comes into play. So, I think it's very valuable. If you just plan on just getting exercise and using capoeira as this awesome exercise, a little bit of martial arts, kickboxing, kicking, dodging, some sweeps and some takedowns, and that's awesome. But as far as really serving my students and serving them as a self-defense tactic, it's essential that I teach grappling to my students. So in your place, it doesn't matter. You can train Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu separately, or if your master teaches you grappling, there's many black belt capoeira masters now. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt capoeira masters now. I did a book, Jinga and Grow Strong, where there's four that I specifically interview and talk about the benefits for capoeira for jiu-jitsu. So it's a little bit the other way, using capoeira as a movement art and flexibility and body strengthening art to help Brazilian jiu-jitsu. So in this case, I'm talking about jiu-jitsu helping your capoeira game. So it does really give you the confidence. If you ever get taken down, someone does go into a grappling situation, it's going to help you out. So I recommend, if you are an instructor, to learning a little bit more grappling and then passing that down to your students, to via training jiu-jitsu, some other kind of grappling art, sambo, whatever. If you are a student, then you could seek out and ask your capoeira instructor to show you more grappling, or if he even knows. They may not. They may just and keep it there for self-defense. Kickboxing. Capoeira kickboxing, where they're kicking and striking and doing takedowns, and that's it, and leaving it there. Or like the way we used to, just minimally doing arm bars and leg locks, ankle locks, all that stuff, but not learning the details of where the hip's supposed to be, the guard, the mounts, all those things like that, how to escape each of those positions. So anyway, it is very helpful for your confidence. And then you could carry yourself in the roda or in the streets with kicking and not worry about if somebody takes you down, you know what to do, and if somebody tries to take you down, you know where to go from there. So that's my take on grappling and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu in Capoeira. Now, they have a little story, a couple of them actually, where one of our affiliate groups, or our old affiliate groups in Colorado, were having a roda, and a visiting instructor came in to the roda and was kind of kicking around some of the younger students who trained Jiu-Jitsu. They slap him in a rear naked choke. He taps out, and he got very upset. Like, hey, that's not capoeira, now it's capoeira. Well, hey, was there music playing? Yeah. Were there people clapping? Were they singing capoeira songs? Was there a circle of people? Yeah. Yes, to all those. So whatever the martial arts that happens inside the hood, I would it could be capoeira, whether it's a punch in the face, a kick in the groin. Now, do I approve of that? Kick in the groin? Probably not. Punch in the face? Maybe if it heats up, you know. Hey, you're kicking at each other's head. Why not punch in the face? It's weird, right? And I understand the people that are going to disagree with me and saying that it's not that it's that's not the style of capoeira. But hey, man, to each his own. So, in that story, the guy was not prepared to defend himself in a grappling match in the Hoda. It could happen. Even friendly style. That happens all the time. Take down, elevates to the next level. Take down, grapple. Okay, escape. What is it? Okay, sprawl. Take down, sprawl. Turtle. All that stuff. I mean, you have to know what the next step. It's very famously said, capoeira is a game of questions and answers. The person who runs out of answers loses. Okay. So, take that with you. So, that's all I have for today. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu or grappling in capoeira. It's a good thing. Okay, go out there, ask your master for that or your instructor if you're looking for that. If you're not ready for that, don't worry. But in time, you can seek that out. But it's definitely beneficial. Until next time, galera.